Welcome to the Sales Influence Podcast, where we talk about finding the why in how people buy. I'm your host, Victor Antonio, and today I want to talk about one of the skill sets you need to have, and this is the ability to tell great stories. Listen carefully. If you can't tell a great story, you're not going to be able to sell your product or service. Now, here's what I want to do. I'm going to give you a formula. Yes, a formula for what needs to be in a great story. In order to tell the right story, you have to have the right formula. Now, I keep repeating the word right because I want you to realize that I'm going to give you an acronym right now. R-I-T-E. Those are the four components that you have to have in your sales presentation to be an excellent storyteller. Let's begin with the R. The R stands for make it relevant. When you're doing a presentation and you're telling your story, make sure it's relevant. So for example, if you're talking to a pest control company and that's who you want to sell, tell a relevant story of another pest control company or something similar that's relevant to the actual listener, the people who are listening to you. Pick stories that relate to them. Too often, people give presentations or examples of presentations of another company in another market sector, and it really doesn't make any sense. It doesn't resonate with the actual listener. So by telling a story that's in the same market, maybe in the same service industry as that company, that becomes relevant to that person listening. And again, what are we trying to do? We're trying to bring the person in during our presentation by telling a story. Second, it has to be insightful. The information has to be relevant to the company, but it also has to be insightful. Now, you remember my definition of insight, information beyond the obvious. Now, here's what customers want. Customers want you to give them information that they don't know. Give them stuff that they haven't heard. Look, if you repeat stuff that's on your brochure or on your website, you're not selling, you're telling. You're repeating information they already know. If you've listened to my past podcast, you know that on average, people will look at 10 sources of information before contacting a vendor. What does that mean? That means that they know a lot. Most buyers today are 50 to 70% into the buying cycle, which means they've done a lot of research, and that to me tells me that they know a lot. So if you walk in there and you're doing a presentation and you're telling them something they already know, you're not selling, you're just telling something and you're doing it poorly. So what insight could you provide? What type of data could you show them? What type of visuals can you use to make them go, I never looked at it that way. See, that's what you want. That's insightful information. When you get the client kind of like, you know, nodding their head going, I never looked at it that way. Well, that's a new perspective. Well, wow, never thought about it that way. That's when you know you're providing insight. So again, if it's relevant information that pertains to that customer, if the information is also insightful as you're telling a story, oh, I think you got them hooked. Now also, let's move to the third component. There's the relevancy, gotta be insightful, but the information you present has to be timely. Listen carefully, this is key. By timely, I mean, give them information of what's currently happening in the market. Let them know, demonstrate through your example, through your information, through your insight, that you understand that their industry is going through some changes. You understand the different market changes that are going on. Maybe there's some regulation changes. Maybe there's some government policies that are going to impact their business. You know, because you're in the mix. You understand this. It's timely information. This is when you start positioning yourself as an expert. Now, if we can make it relevant, give them insightful information, make the information timely so it makes sense to them, then the last part is the E in the right. And that is to be engaging, but I'm going to cheat here. You also have to put the customer at ease. Now let's talk about the E here. Engaging information. By using stories that relate to the customer, you begin to engage the customer that much more. But also, you want to put the customer at ease, because let's think about this. Let's kind of mentally walk through this together. You're trying to sell them. Let's say this is a B2B example. You're trying to sell them, let's say, a $300,000 system. In their mind, they want to know, is this relevant to me? Changing over to this type of system, this type of software, using your service is relevant. We need to do this now. Providing insight, that's telling them, hey, this is why you need to change. You're trying to shift their mindset. You're talking about the market changes. That's timely. But you also have to engage them. You have to let them know that they need to be doing certain things if they want to stay ahead of the game, if they want to increase their revenue, reduce their costs, expand their market share. You remember the value trinity. How can you make it more engaging? But also, they're afraid. Listen carefully. Customers are afraid. They're afraid to buy. They're afraid to make a big decision. One study by B2B Circle Research found that on average, it takes 7 people in a B2B sales to sign off on a deal. 7 people. Think about that. It takes 7 people to sign off on a deal. Now, why does it take 7 people? Because people are more cautious today. Look, there was a time where they would just throw money at a project, switch over, and it wasn't a big deal. But in today's market, guess what? It doesn't work that way. People are afraid. Customers are afraid. So our job is to put the customer at ease. How do you do that? Show them how you're going to implement this new software. Show them how you're going to use this new service that you're offering. Show them that the switchover, the ability to move from what you have to what they're currently offering, is going to be easy. Let them know that the path to success with you is not that hard. So let me recap here because I want you to get this. If you can make it relevant, if you can provide insightful information, if you can make it timely, but also engaging and put the customer's mind at ease, guess what's going to happen? They're more likely to move in your direction because many customers today know that they need to do something to stay competitive in the market. So if you're going in there, here's what I want you to do. I want you to have at least, let's say you do a 45-minute presentation. In that 45-minute presentation, I want you to have at least 2 or 3 validating stories, the right stories. These are stories that are going to be relevant to the customer. And in those stories, you're going to provide insight. You're going to tell them something that maybe they did, this customer did, that maybe they want to try. You also want to make sure that the information is timely as you're telling them the story. This is what's happening in the market now. This is what other competitors are doing. This is what other companies are doing that are in your market industry. And last but not least, make it engaging. You would put them at ease that if they were to move in your direction, buy your product or your service, that you would make the transition easier. That is what customers want today. So if you can deliver the right presentation, you will be more effective at selling, but more importantly, you'll be able to close more deals. That's it for this Sales Influence podcast. Don't forget to leave me some feedback on iTunes, Stitcher, or YouTube. Let me know what you think. I would greatly appreciate it. Also, check out my sales training website, seminarsonselling.com, where you'll find great training videos for your team to help you grow your business so you can do what? Make more money. Lastly, I want to thank you for listening. This is Victor Antonio, always reminding you, selling ain't hard when you know how. Take care.
Every manager can feel it. The difference between a motivated, value-driven sales team and one that's stuck in a rut. CEOs know the difference too. They can see it clearly in the profit and loss columns. The question is, how do you get your team to this elite level? Is there something extra you can do to break through the remaining resistance and equip them with the right mindset to grow your business? Yes, there is. But you're not going to do it with one of those cheesy inspirational speakers or some self-proclaimed guru. What you need is someone with a real business track record to deliver key insights in a captivating way, to give your team the right tools for selling in today's tough marketplace. Enter Victor Antonio, experienced executive, innovative thinker, compelling speaker. He's ready to deliver the message you need your people to hear, not with a canned speech, but a customized, dynamic keynote designed to deliver results. Bring Victor Antonio to your next event before the competition does.